Hello and welcome back to Matt's World. In this episode, I'm interviewing the wonderful Caito, CEO of Beige Flags.
Hi.
So pleased to have you here.
Happy to be here.
Great. You've flown down to Melbourne for this, which I'm ever so grateful for.
How could I not? Honestly, with a setup like this,
right?
How could I not?
We actually met on my podcast, maybe in COVID when I was in London virtually.
It was like 2.5 years ago or like 2 years
really?
Ago. Yeah.
Because
it was 2022 that it all like popped off.
That is actually so mad.
Yeah.
What the hell? And I asked you to come on because you invented Beige Flags, the TikTok phenomenon.
Yes.
Because you were reviewing people's Hinge profiles to ask how beige they are. Like, tell me everything, how it started, what made you want to do it, and then what it led to. Obviously, coming on this podcast is the greatest achievement you've ever had in your entire life.
Obviously, actually returned to the podcast as well.
And now we're also real life friends, which is like, what the fuck? We literally,
the internet's crazy, man.
Isn't it? We literally, I did this for so many people. Like, not that you're not like the most special one, but I feel like now
I do this with everyone. It doesn't matter.
Yeah, it means nothing to me. But I feel like, because I had 100 episodes of the audio podcast, I've just made so many mates online that are now just normal friends. Like,
yeah.
Saggy Sarah, because I obviously run The Void, which is my influencer talent agency.
Uh-huh.
Now she's just my client and friend. And I'm like, this is, look what Matt's one has done for the people, you know?
Literally, even like the TikTok stuff that I was doing, people that followed me, I ended up being friends with a few of them.
I love that. So tell me all about it. I want to know everything.
So, I don't know. I was just doing TikToks like for fun. Mm-hmm. Because when you work in content, you have to know how they all work. So I was just making them, putting them out there. And I was like, out into the void. The void.
The void.
Just sending it out into the void. Different void.
So it's all the same void, baby. That's the whole point. It's just
and being like, void. It was all just like my outfits and stuff. And then I had been talking to my friends for a while because I've been single for a very long time.
Mm-hmm. If you're watching this and you're interested, just give me a DM and I'll hook you up.
You know,
and that's on period
and that's on I'm still single. And so obviously in the trenches on the dating apps when you're single for a long time, like you just go on and off them, you give up, you go back, you come crawling back, like, and it's the same shit every time.
Mm-hmm.
And it's, you see the same prompt answers, you see the same kind of photos, you're like, this is just clones like 1,000 times over. So I started describing it to my friends. I was like, if these people had a flag, because people would be like, oh my God, are there so many red flags out there? And I was like, if these people had a flag, it would be calico. Like, it would just be like, like so bland.
Plain chips.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Like not even salt. Like,
yeah. Ew.
And so I describe a lot of things that I find boring as like beige, just like, it's just like a common word for it.
Yeah.
But I was like, if their flag's made of calico, the flag is beige. Like, you know what I mean?
I know what you mean. Yeah, they're waving the boring flag.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So I'd been kind of explaining that to people in like real life and they were like, oh my God, that's hilarious. And then I was like, fuck it, I'll make a TikTok about it because I had a list of things that I was like, these are the beige flags. Like,
yeah.
And as soon as I made that video, it went off. It was all like pineapple on pizza and like using your dog as your personality and like,
yeah,
talking about The Office, and it's like, no hate to The Office, but
we
like,
were just watching The Office.
We were just watching The Office.
What the fuck?
But like, everyone likes The Office. Like, that's not saying anything about you.
Mm-hmm.
So I put that video up. It went off.
Mm-hmm.
And then I started getting people messaging me being like, okay, can you tell me if I'm beige? And they would send me their own like Hinge or Bumble profile.
Because you became like the oracle, the beige oracle.
Quite literally. Like, yeah. I made a few more videos like expanding my list of things that were beige flags.
Mm-hmm.
And then I started getting sent profiles. Mm-hmm. And so I was like, yeah, fuck it, I'll do one.
Love that.
And so I turned it into kind of a game show.
Mm-hmm.
It was called Are You Beige? And it was just me going through their profile screenshots or like videos or whatever. And like picking out what the beige flags were. And if you hit 3, you were out, like you were done. So then obviously everyone would get involved in the comments. It was so much fun.
Love that.
But I reckon I got like 800 plus profiles.
That's hectic.
Yeah.
And you actually reviewed my Hinge profile recently and you classified me as beige, which it's not like I took personal offense to you. I was just disappointed in myself.
Because beige is not like a death sentence. It's literally just like, where is the stuff on here that makes you you? And like, I could look at, because I know you, I could look at it and be like, this isn't like what you get when you meet Mads in person. Like, sure, it's like hot and it's like, it got some decent like prompt answers, I guess, but like, it's not really you.
And the thing is, like, I can actually testify that Caito's method works, because after I got classified as beige, I was like, right, I feel like I'm the opposite of beige. I mean, look around, like, I'm probably more of like a cool pink, if that makes sense.
You've got a lot of shit going on.
Honestly, and my profile, I think it's because I went through a phase in London where I was like, I had such a bad self-esteem and I hated how I looked and stuff. And then I was just like, I just couldn't be asked to like be anything but hot. And then I don't know if that sounds shallow or something, but I was just super depressed. And then I was like, do you know what? I just can't be bothered putting in any effort. I'm just going to choose old hot pics of me where I felt really confident, whatever. And I was thinking like, what, who would swipe no? Like, I look so cute. But then if I see a hot guy's profile and there's nothing for me to reply to, or it's boring, I don't care how hot you are, I'm always saying no. Like,
exactly. I called that, I did a few TikToks on that where I would be going through someone's profile. I'm like, the only thing you have going on here is that you're hot.
Yeah.
I called it hot girl beige, where it's like, this is not an influencer's Instagram. Like, this is not like
real.
This is, you're trying to meet people and show them the person that you are. So I did like quite a lot of interviews when all of this was popping off.
Yeah.
And I got asked all the time, like, what is your like number one advice to people like when building out their profile to avoid being beige, which is basically just an indicator that you're boring, you're not willing to make any effort. Like, it's kind of, it's like a warning sign, but a warning sign for like, this probably isn't going to be very good. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
not 100%. Like, you're not going to end up traumatized, but you're also going to be like, why do I bother?
And I feel like Hinge gives you the opportunity to actually show some of your personality. Yeah. Like the other apps,
it's gotten
like,
a lot better.
Yeah. Bumble and Tinder and like some of the others where you just choose profiles and then write whatever you want. At least on Hinge, like they're kind of like, okay, like this is your moment. Like you can answer this question. We've made it literally so easy for you. Like just give it a go.
Yeah.
But, I can testify that your method worked, because I changed one of my photos to this picture of me. I'll put it right here in the edit of me with snot coming out my nose. And I asked all my Instagram followers, should I put this up? I swear to God, my like success rate has gone through the roof.
Yes. It's so like relatable, queen.
Yeah.
And also like shows, because the thing about like, because you're mostly dating men.
Yeah.
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 So the thing about like guys I find is that they're just like, I just want someone to be like fun and silly in themselves,
just
but like
funny. And also like whatever,
they think they want someone hot, but they want someone that they can like have a laugh with.
They want someone that was ugly or a nerd in school, so they've had that character building personality factor,
and then we glowed up and now we're hot and funny.
So fucking real.
That's the secret. So I always said that like the most important thing to identify is like, I mean, we're marketing girlies. Like,
yeah, that's actually so true. We know how to sell. Like, I work in influencer marketing and sales, and you work in marketing. It's like,
it's
that must actually help. Okay.
Well, I think because I work in marketing, I thought about it. You think about it a little bit differently to like how the general person would, which is like, what are your USPs? Which in marketing is your unique selling points.
Yeah.
Which is basically, what can I bring to the table that thousands of other people can't necessarily, or that like is a little bit less common. It doesn't have to be like something fucking wild that's like only you do this, but like it's like move away from the generic answers, move away from like not committing to building your profile, and just start to be like, okay, is this an accurate representation of my personality? Because even though like you've experienced, even though you might get maybe less matches, but you'll get better ones.
Yeah. And we've asked our followers, and so you guys watching, of your biggest Hinge turn-ons and turn-offs. And I feel like the turn-offs pretty much align with like beige flags usually, like they're quite generic. But I would say my biggest turn-offs, should we do each other's? Like my biggest turn-offs are things like traveling photos.
Yeah.
Because I'm like, I feel like because I'm 30, everyone's been traveling, and so many guys just have that Machu Picchu photo where they're like, they've done like the 3-day hike or whatever. I'm like, yeah, it's probably like one of the only pictures you've got of yourself, because guys don't take pictures. But I'm like, bro, whatever. Like, I don't care that you did that. Like, I know that sounds so mean, but I'm like, I don't care that you like went to the Greek islands on a Kentucky like 8 years ago. Just put something, even just put a picture of like you in Fitzroy or you with your mom. Like
it's fully, what do you do now?
Tells me more about you. You
like,
know?
What are you up to like now?
Right now.
Not like a decade ago when you were hot and went on Kentucky. Yeah.
Like, Machu pitch off, piss off. Fucked that up.
We get the vibe.
We get the vibe.
We get the vibe.
What's your turn offs?
I generally am just saying no to anyone. So my feed is set to like pretty much everyone.
Mm-hmm.
So mine is just like if you've obviously not made much effort,
yeah,
boring. Then no.
Oh, like when people just do like a dot for the answers on here.
I hate that.
Like, what? Like you couldn't spend 10 minutes? Like what? I have nothing to say to you.
I also find that I really avoid people who put in their love language because I just feel like that's become such a thing.
And guys always.
And I just can't explain to you how many men on their profiles like my love language. It's physical touch. And you're like fucking is it?
Obviously, because you don't have a personality and you don't have a brain.
Well, they're like, I want to touch you, sex. So.
I like doing it, actually.
Yeah.
When wow. I like a girl, I want to touch her.
And it's like, I understand that love languages is like a way that people can communicate, but I feel like that's just like not something I need to know up front is that your love language is physical touch because I'm like, well, if I'm on a first date, I don't want to know that you're trying to touch me.
Yeah, get away.
Like, I'm not a touchy person.
You're overstimulating me. Get your hands off.
Yeah. But to be fair, it's probably good to know that up front. But I don't know, something about that just icks me out a little bit.
Same, because I don't know. I think it's just...
I think because it's become beige, like so many people put in their profiles, like my love languages, it's always physical touch, like pretty much always.
Well, when people say stuff like overused stuff like, the best way to ask me out is by... asking me out.
Oh, I hate that one.
Like, okay, I'll ask you out and then they literally don't reply or they just ghost you or they just stop answering. I'm like,
yeah.
Oh, so if that was the best way to ask you out and it didn't work, like, I don't see any other ways.
Yeah.
Because that's the only way.
Yeah. Another one that one of my friends did send in and I also agree with it is fully when they have like their Instagram bio. In their profile.
Okay, like, yeah, that's like they're trying to get followers.
In a prompt. And I'm like, this isn't like...
This isn't for you to get followers.
My opinion with dating apps is we all don't really love that we have to be on them.
Yeah, annoying.
But if you are on them, you play the game.
Yeah.
Play the game. Like...
Commit to the bit.
Message on their app first. Mm-hmm. That's how you've met.
Yeah.
I don't want people sliding into my DMs like any app. And it's like, you're only going to get people that think it's okay to just like slide into your Instagram.
And also, this is so funny, but I didn't have my Instagram connected. I kept saying to people like, oh, let's just talk on Insta because I'm so shit at checking the apps and I can't be asked. But then I went viral for saying all this shit about how men suck and men are bad at dating. And then news.com.au wrote an article about it. And then all the guys that I'd asked that week to like message me on Insta, they're all like, and I actually had a date with a guy that week and he fully, we were meant to go out that night. And I was like, oh, we're still good for tonight. And this was when the article had been published and he's like, oh, I've had a family emergency. And I was like,
you didn't tell me it was the same day.
No, genuinely so embarrassing. And I was like, okay. Like, he's obviously seen the article and gone. Oh, and then this other guy, I did this too. And then he came back on Hinge and goes, you didn't tell me you were a nano influencer celebrity who gets interviewed by news.com.au. And I was like, well, I'm blocking you. I don't want to talk to you anymore.
I actually contain multitudes.
Yeah, I actually have lots of things going on.
Yeah, imagine every single person you ever talk to on a dating app finding that out and being like, so am I beige?
Yeah.
Well, you wouldn't have fucking made it this far if you were.
Yeah, so real. Another thing that no one has an original answer to is the ideal Sunday prompt.
Oh.
Because it's either you're hungover or you're not.
Or you're going on a coastal walk and getting a coffee.
We live in an island surrounded by water.
The majority of the population in this country is like, the beach is pretty accessible.
Literally, have you seen Central Australia? There's no one there. We're all on the coast. We're all on the coast.
Doing our coastal walks on Sunday.
Genuinely. Or they're like, coffee and a walk. And it's like,
as the Bondi to Bronte or the Bondi to Coogee walk will attest, everyone's out doing their fucking coastal walks on a Sunday.
And or they're just like a sesh head and they're hungover, which in which case it's one or two things. And either way, I don't care.
But also I'm like, yeah, that's just what Sundays are for. Like, that's a bad prompt from Hinge, in my opinion.
Yeah, because so real.
It litmus tests in terms of, like, are they going out every weekend or are they, like, wholesome?
Mm-hmm. You can test if it's, like, your kind of energy.
Yes, but I just feel like Hinge maybe needs to make a little, like, roll through their prompts a little bit.
Little tweaks.
Faster. Yeah. And so, like, have something that can also tell the same thing. Or it's, like, my ideal Saturday night or something. Like, just change it up so that we're not having to look at the same prompt answers.
That's interesting. Like, shuffle them around a bit more and stuff.
I think they should... I mean, they do add more prompts pretty often, but I think some of them need to either be redone or refreshed, or because like a user end perspective, it's like, how many times do I have to see someone's ideal fucking Sunday being a coastal walk with a coffee?
Hinge, if you're watching this, app developers, I'm just going to say some stuff for SEO so they find this.
They.
Apps, numbers, computers, dating apps.
Algorithms.
They should find it.
Yeah. Right? Yeah. No, that's actually done now.
Science. All right, more Hinge turn offs that you guys submitted. Someone said anything Brat Summer. I think it's died now. And
it's a bit too bandwagon-y.
Yeah, very much so. And also, like,
it does show that they've updated their profile in the last 3 months though.
That is actually so true. But yeah, I feel like Brat Summer loved it. Loved it. Like, loved it.
Look,
you know,
I would like to live my life as Brat Summer.
I do.
But I feel like you just need to show that through what you put through your pictures and your other prompts and stuff, you can give the energy of Brat Summer without having to say Brat Summer like every other fucker is.
Real. Someone else said for their Hinge turnoffs, when people say, I hate these apps or hate Hinge prompts, or my biggest fear is Hinge prompts. It's like,
hey, again, play the game. Like, you're on this app.
Like, you're not too cool to be here because you're literally here.
Yeah, and so are all of us. And I'm sorry, but
don't make me feel bad.
If answering a prompt makes you stressed, this is not for you. Like, get off. Don't waste my time.
All of this.
Don't waste my time.
I'm going to stress you out more than a little Hinge prompt.
Yeah.
Like, believe
you
that.
Think a Hinge prompt's your biggest problem?
Yeah. You got another thing coming, honey.
I'm just getting started.
All right. More Hinge turn-offs. Someone wrote, messaging loads without meeting, morning beautiful from a guy I've never met is an egg. So true. You only know what I look like on Instagram, and in real life, I'm totally busted.
I always call myself freelance hot. So it's like, I'm hot on my own hours. You know what I mean?
Yeah, on,
like,
my time.
I will be hot when I need to be hot.
Literally.
And the rest of the time, busted, gremlin.
This is like a 2024 way of saying, if you can't handle me at my worst, you don't deserve me at my best.
It's freelance hot. I'll be hot when I feel like it.
Freelance hot is, the abbreviated. It's kind of like the shorter abbreviated way of saying that. The Marilyn Monroe quote, and I love it.
Yeah.
Hot on your terms, and you invoice when you can be asked.
Exactly. The rest of the time, busted.
Yeah, absolutely busted.
But the good morning, beautiful message, it's a bit icky.
It's gross.
If you haven't met them in person.
Yeah, you don't know that I'm beautiful. So what you're saying is you're stupid.
It's giving the same kind of energy that comes from, like, those spammy messages from, like.
Yeah, hot singles in your area. Like.
Or, like, good morning, beautiful. Can I send you some money? It's like sugar daddy messages in the spam.
Show me Bob's and Virginia. Yeah. Fucking forgot about that.
Oh, it's funny every time.
Oh, my God.
Good morning, beautiful. Bob's and Virginia.
Bob's and Virginia? Question mark? Fucking hell. Oh, my God. This next one. This actually. No, I was in tears when I read this. Hinge turnoffs when people write things like consent is hot, and I'm like, nah, it's the law. So fucking true. Like, yeah, that's hot. No, like, it's just the law.
Oh my God. I'm on Field, which is another dating app, which is a little bit more like, I don't know, like open and like.
Yeah.
All that kind of thing. And on there, it's like, consent is so sexy. And I'm like, hey, no, legally also.
Also, I would like to provide it even if you don't think
like it's sexy on field. Like, it's like open bio. Yeah. And I'm like, you've chosen your open bio to be like, don't worry, I'll be asking for consent because I think it's hot. And it's like
you should anyway. Like, even consensual non-consent still has to work consensual.
Like, is that not like, can we all operate on the same baseline, please?
Yeah.
Legally speaking.
Can we just agree that consent is just, consent is not hot or not hot. It's not hot or not hot. It's just the baseline.
It's not like objective.
Yeah.
Subjective? Objective.
Subjective.
It's not subjective. It's objectively a legal requirement.
Yep. So, and that's on that.
Exactly.
Hinge turn-offs, when people write, I'm weirdly attracted to, red flags. Boring.
So boring.
And not true, because if that was true, then you're insane.
They're coming on here to be like, I want a fucking crazy girl.
I want
to
ruin your life. And it's just like, you like tell them like not to go out with the boys on the weekend. And that's how they ruin your life.
Like, I don't even know what to say to that.
Yeah.
Like, what are you looking for, a toxic relationship?
Yeah. And like,
or are you just saying that like previously all of your relationships have been toxic? And it's like, hey, fully, you're the common denominator.
Yeah. I think they're just trying to be funny, but it's like,
it's not funny.
It's not funny because everyone says it and it's just shit. So well done.
I mean, I literally invented a flag color and the flag's overdone.
Yeah. Yeah. This one's so fucking funny contextually. So I matched with this guy recently. His name's Jamie. I'll just name him. I don't even care. But he's
we see you.
I'm actually going out with him this week. So by the time this goes live, who knows? Maybe we'll be.
You might be married.
Might be in love. Don't know. But he's a graphic designer, and so I put up an Instagram story because I wanted the Mads World logo. Like, I wanted it to look like red latex, just because it's like it matches my phone and it's just a bit like sexy and
bit
funny.
Saucy, yeah.
Bit saucy. And then he was like, oh, I'll do it. And I was like, oh, cool. Like, just invoice me like however much it is and whatever. And then he just invoiced me $0 and just did it for me. And then
that's so nice.
And he's just submitted his Hinge turn-offs getting used for graphics. Whoops.
Look, you cannot undervalue having a good graphic designer
genuinely
on hand.
And I swear to God, it was the first one he did, no amends. Like, it looked amazing.
Because it's quite literally me fighting for my life in Canva otherwise.
Yeah. Like, he did this fully in Photoshop, I think. So thank you so much for doing that. Someone wrote, Hinge turn-offs, roast dinner and a walk. Surely there's no roast dinners left, man.
It's the same as the coastal.
Yeah.
I feel like that's the English version. It's English, like Sunday roast and a walk.
Got a lot of English followers out there. So, yeah, it's the same thing. It's like a Sunday at, like, Broadway Market in London. Yeah. Coffee, like up early, you know. It's just like, okay, we get it. But then it's also like these people wouldn't have slept and, like, would be up all night doing coke. You know, it's like,
you know, it's called balance.
It's balance. But that's also the thing about that prompt is, like, it is about balance. Yeah, you can go out and party and, yeah, you can go get coffee, but, like, you know, I don't want to define my Sundays to one little Hinge prompt.
I do something different every Sunday.
I could go to a museum. I could go see my parents. I could go and, like, hang out with them. Like,
again, I contain multitudes.
Yeah, we're just multifaceted girls that are also hot. So,
and that's on that.
And that's on that. Did you have any more Hinge turn-offs?
Ooh, Hinge turn-offs. Saying that they're not political or moderate. Just say you're conservative and spineless.
That is fucking real. Moderate is so funny. It's
moderate's like I just want to maximize my chances, like, with everyone.
I love racist jokes in closed doors, behind closed doors.
Yeah, yeah. If I say it, it's funny.
Yeah. And I'm also a white guy.
Yeah.
I'm straight. And that's on period. Yeah, that's fucking annoying. People's Hinge turn-ons that I had were videos and voice notes was a turn-on that people had for Hinge.
See, I have always said this in every, like, video that I've, like, profile I've reviewed.
Mm-hmm.
The voice notes make me uncomfy.
And why do people act? Why do so many guys act like the voice notes on Hinge can't be re-recorded? Like they'll start it and they'll go, right.
Or
ideal Sunday. So like you can just do another take.
Why do they always need it to be some kind of bit?
Honestly, they're ones that I do like is when they if it's overdone now, it's becoming beige. It's like, enjoy this elevator music while you scroll my profile. And I'm like, that's kind of funny.
The first few times I was like, this is good. Or like a theme song or something to your profile. Like, this is good. And now I'm like, okay, everybody's
done. Okay, but the other day someone did have the Linkin Park song that like is in every Michael Bay movie at the end. And it's like goes towards the credit and like it'll be like the character's dead and then their finger like twitches slightly. It was so good. And I was scrolling. I'm like, actually, yeah, this goes off. This
what would
so
yours funny. Be?
My Hinge turn-ons.
No, your song for your profile. Fuck.
I would probably say the Linkin Park song. Or do you know what it would be? It would be the Jurassic Park song when he goes, welcome to Jurassic Park. And then it's like, yeah. And then it's actually, do you know what? I'm going to play it. Can you hear that?
I can. This is nice.
Yeah. I'll skip ahead when it gets a bit more epic.
Yeah, nice.
Yeah, like that would be my Hinge scroll. Like, yeah, you get the idea.
Yeah.
So I feel like something a bit epic like that. What would yours be?
Easily the Cusco theme song from Emperor's New Groove.
Stunning. Okay. What's his name?
Immaculate vibes.
Yeah, and it would say, Caito. Nice. I love that. That's really well suited. Well done.
Yeah.
You nailed that. You nailed
the breeze.
Did you have any more Hinge turn ons?
I've got a couple.
Mm-hmm.
So Hinge turn on, Crocs stay on in bed.
Oh, wow.
As a croc enthusiast, I stand by that.
As in, like, that's just a life turn on, or they say it on Hinge?
I think people have said that on Hinge.
Funny. Sport mode for that, definitely.
Mentioning crocs on your Hinge, I can verify, does get you answers.
Really?
Yeah, it gets you, like people will message rather than just, like, send likes for that one.
Yeah, I'm not really a croc enthusiast, but I see the appeal. I'm a comfort enthusiast, so look at me.
Yeah.
Got my Undertaker jumper on. Do you like it?
I
actually got food on it.
Love it.
It's good. It was a dollar.
And I just... What a steal.
I know.
I'm jealous.
Dollar from Camberwell Market, so hope you love that one, guys.
So
I'm actually also a fashion influencer, so.
Not to brag.
Not to brag or anything, but yeah. I had a turn on, getting to the point and arranging to meet up. So real. Just meet up with me.
Yeah.
Like, I don't want to message, I don't want a pen pal, I don't want to message you for like 10 years. Just literally let's
I do out. Have a caveat to that in that I need to message you for long enough to determine that you're probably not a serial killer.
Actually, yeah.
But I, like, within 3 days.
Yeah, and at least if you're talking on Instagram, I feel you can gauge if they're a serial killer or not by the
pictures. Yes, like, but I hate when they ask, turn off for me is when they ask straight away.
Yeah, okay.
That's,
yeah, actually.
That's weird because I'm like, you're just some random man or like some person.
Actually,
like,
that's so true. I feel like I'm just lazy. So I'm like, yeah, cool, let's hang out,
but
whatever.
I also am like, I'm not really here looking for a pen pal, so let's get to the point eventually.
Yeah, fair. Did you have any more Hinge turn-ons?
Just one more.
Mm-hmm.
Same haircut as me is a yes almost always.
Wait, what?
When they have the same haircut.
Okay, yeah. So like what? Short, long, doesn't matter.
Well, whatever. The guy sent this has like shoulder length curly hair.
Love that. Do you know what? If I had like a shag or a mullet, I'd say same.
Huh? Yeah.
Like, yeah, love that.
In my case, I'm like, that's probably a bit mullet.
In my case, I'd be like dating Lucius Malfoy. Like,
yeah, but like. Daddy.
Kind of slay.
Kind of slay though.
I had one more that I want to share. And it was the same guy who said it was a turn off getting used for graphics. So it was also a turn on for him. So thanks, Jamie, for that one.
Look.
Love that.
I said it before, I'll say it again. Sometimes you just need a graphics guy on hand.
And sometimes you got to mix business with pleasure because it's very sexy.
And the results are some really great latex lettering.
The results are sexy.
The results are sexy.
Jesus Christ. Right. Well, you've put together your 5 golden rules for Hinge as well.
Mm-hmm.
Because you are the CEO of Beige Flags and a Hinge expert, and I can vouch that Caito's method actually works because it has worked for me. So tell us your top 5 golden rules for Hinge.
Okay. This is the secret to an anti-beige Hinge profile.
Okay.
Your first photo needs to be a solo photo, full face. We need to see your eyeballs. This is also on the Hinge like guidelines, like their actual official like recommended guidelines.
Love that.
And I like to think
work, guys.
That they got that from me.
I
actually
think they did too. Also, it's just like not rocket science. If I see a photo of 2 guys, I'm going to assume you're the uglier one.
Or a group photo.
Yeah, I don't know who you are and I can't be asked figuring it out.
And you know what the rule is?
Mm.
They always are the uglier one.
Yeah, because why would you use a picture of you and your hot mate unless you were pretending to be him? Sorry, it's giving Barton Milhouse.
Like, don't make it difficult for me. This is already shit.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Easy.
So, rule number 2.
Mm-hmm.
Good mix of photos. You have to show different aspects of your life. You can't just have all hot ones. You can't just have all you out drinking with your mates, in cute outfits. I think it's really important to have like a little snot photo or just like something to keep it humble.
Yeah, and not just all traveling either. Like even if you're in different countries, it's the same shit. You know, it's all the same thing. Like if you were in Southeast Asia or you're in Eastern Europe, you're just, it tells me the same thing.
Yeah.
You like traveling, which is cool, but just do one.
Yeah. And just have something that's a little bit gremlin in there, you know?
Yeah. Something a little bit funny. Just be funny. It's not that deep.
Yep. Rule number 3, if you don't have these photos, like a good mix of photos, go get them. That's homework. I don't care what you have to do. I cannot tell you how many profiles I still see, which is wild, of just like, it's almost like they've been like, use camera when they're setting up the profile and they're just...
Yeah, like a 50-year-old uncle on Facebook has just gone, take
so
photo,
grim.
Bang, upload.
Yeah, no. And it's like, people are like, oh, I don't have photos of myself. You got to get them. That's what self-timer is for.
Just get some, bro.
Because those photos where you're looking straight on as a selfie, I call them skin suits because you look like you're going to wear my skin as a suit.
Or they're already doing it and they're an alien.
Fully, they give serial killer energy.
Yeah, that's fucked up. And they're always like in bed and they're just like staring down the barrel like,
yeah,
you are honestly terrifying.
It's right unsettling.
Now. Yeah, love that.
4 is do not use generic prompt answers or ones that you've seen a lot or seem like an easy answer or just copying out of answering at all. Actually think about what best conveys your personality. So that's like what I talked about with USPs. It's like actually go through the prompts and be like, which one of these can I answer in a way that most people aren't going to answer?
And you know what? This is a really good tip is I always now will just reply to someone's prompt rather than just like, I used to just be lazy with it. But now I'm like, if you reply to someone's prompt, you just end up having a convo about something actually funny or interesting rather than how are you?
Well, that's kind of the point of the prompts is that you've fully started a conversation.
Yeah.
So you need to use them in a way that will fully start a conversation.
Yeah. And something that's easy for people to reply to that's like funny. If it's just like, I like going on a walk on a Sunday.
I have nothing to say to that.
Like, I don't. Like, what do you want me to say? There's like, at least like, just do the work for me.
Yes, exactly.
Are we on number 4 now?
That was number 4.
Mm-hmm.
And my last one, we've kind of covered it already, but it's fill out the stuff for Christ's sake. Like,
commit
to the bit, play the game. This, the whole concept of dating apps does not work unless everybody buys in.
Yeah.
Which is why I'm like, everyone hates them because no one's committing properly. So it's just boring. How much better would it be if everyone was putting their authentic selves on dating apps
and actually trying their little
So do not full stop the prompt answers. Do not.
And if you're complaining that dating apps are boring, check yourself before you wreck yourself.
Exactly. Do a little bit of looking inwards. See what you can do to improve it, because honestly, like, you didn't even realize with your profile.
I was like, oh, it's hot, it'll do.
You're like, wow, why does it suck on here? But it's like, that's because it's not a bad profile, but there's so many things, like little things that can be tweaked that'll just make it pop that much more.
And now I just have loads of matches with actual people I actually like.
And even if, and like,
But I mean, obviously we're both single. So if you want to be like us, listen to our advice. But that's some period.
But you know what? The overall experience, even if you're not getting like, you know, getting a husband or like meeting a partner out of this.
Yeah.
you'll at least have a way better time, or you'll go on better dates, or you'll just have better conversations.
Literally, that's exactly what's happened to me. And now I'm like, got a few dates this week, and which I'm just chatting to a few people. Like, it's just actually engaging and it's actually fun. And
it,
like,
keeps you wanting to be in the game.
Yeah, exactly. And yeah, it doesn't make it seem so dire. Because at least if you, I feel like I've made, like, hello, I got a logo designed.
Like, hey, I've, yeah, fully a business opportunity there.
Got an employee, really.
Yeah, basically.
And that's all five ways to improve your Hinge by the CEO of Beige Flags, the lovely Caito MacPhail. Thank you so much for joining me on this episode.
Oh my God, you're so welcome.
I know. Well, let's just go and get some lunch or something, I guess.
Yeah, yeah. I guess. Snack time.
Slay.
Bye.